Hi guys, welcome to OpenIO Story Store. I am Enrico Signoretti and in this video I want to talk about the different types of storage and compare their main characteristics to understand better the use cases and the kind of application they are best suited for. Let's start with the block storage. This kind of storage system is usually located close to the server, in the same data center, and it organizes data in separate volumes accessed by one or very few servers simultaneously. The volumes have the layout of local hard disks, presented in the form of sectors and tracks. Most common access protocols are FC and iSCSI, and all of the communication happens on a dedicated storage area network based on lossless Ethernet or FC equipment. This type of storage is very good for databases and virtual machines, and more in general for all those workloads that require low latency and high IOPS. Unfortunately, block storage systems are also characterized by a very high cost per gigabyte, and most of the implementation in the market still rely on scale-up dual controller designs, with a total capacity that can hardly reach the petabyte level, while maintaining a good performance consistency. The limited scalability drives up complexity and costs in large capacity scenarios. In the last few years, all-flash arrays have become more common, and now they count for a good part of primary storage sales. Flash memory is still 10 times more expensive than hard drives, though. But again, the goal remains absolute performance here, and thanks to its very high speed and the kind of data stored in the system, it is possible to implement advanced techniques to reduce the data footprint, including data duplication and compression, alongside snapshot and thin provisioning, mechanisms which are of help in reducing the cost to a reasonable level. The second option is file-based storage, or NAS. This type of storage system is connected to the local hard network, accessed by servers as well as other types of clients such as PC. Data is organized in a hierarchy of files and directories, shared through protocols like SMB and NFS. Because of the additional file system and the network layers, performance figures are not as consistent as for block storage, but this kind of storage system can easily reach very high throughput, making them good for a large set of use cases and all non-latency-driven workloads, where scalability is not the key. In fact, most of the systems available in the market are still scale-up, and only few of them show scale-out capabilities due to architectural limitation and file systems. The dollar per gigabyte of NAS systems is usually lower than block devices, also because they are often configured in an hybrid configuration. A limited amount of flash memory is aimed at serving frequently accessed data and metadata quickly, backed by a large pool of hard disks. Caching mechanisms and automated tiering functionalities are in charge of data movements between different storage tiers. Multi-petabyte installations are now more common than in the past, but the cost of these systems is still high and they can become complex to manage when capacity increases. Object storage is a totally different story. This kind of storage is designed to offer the best accessibility and reliability at a scale, making possible to connect any type of device from anywhere from any sort of network connection which can support protocols like HTTP. Depending on the implementation, also access parallelization becomes a key characteristic, allowing millions of devices to access the same information simultaneously. It is not a case that sometimes object storage is referred as the storage backbone of the cloud. Data is stored in the form of an object, which is made of data itself, usually standard file, associated with rich metadata fields and unique key. Contrary to what happens in file system hierarchy, objects are stored in a flat namespace and can be retrieved by searching metadata or knowing the key. This is also why object storage is considered a very good option for storing large sets of unstructured data. The most common protocol to access an object store is S3, which is also the name of a public cloud service provided by Amazon AWS. Even though S3 is not as common as file or block interfaces, the number of solutions supporting it is increasing by the day, providing a seamless access to the object store for legacy applications, by adding a gateway, for example, or directly from the application themselves. Because of its scale-out nature, the access protocol involved and potential network issues between the storage system and the device accessing data, latency is not consistent at all, but throughput could be massive. Many modern object stores have strong multi-tenant capabilities, enabling end users to consolidate several types of data and workloads in a single system. This helps to simplify and drive down the TCO of the entire infrastructure. Common object storage implementations show similar characteristics and very high scalability when compared to block and file storage. The dollar per gigabyte figure is also very low, and multi-petabyte installations are pretty common. These systems are scaled out, with each single node in the cluster taking care of a certain amount of capacity. Flash memory is used for storing metadata only, and hybrid or flash configurations are very rare and aimed at solving very specific use cases. Traditional data footprint reduction techniques like deduplication or compression are not really applicable here, mostly because it is more and more common that unstructured data already comes in compressed and encrypted formats. On the other hand, rigid coding or more recently distributed rigid coding techniques improve overall efficiency and durability when data chunks are dispersed in several nodes or locations. I hope this video gave you an idea of the differences between storage systems. You can find more information on our website www.openio.io, or you can follow us on Twitter. And see you soon for a new episode of OpenIO Storage Talk. Bye bye!